Iran's weapon manufacturing machine is not limited to missiles and drones. They have reached military deterrence because they can make homegrown advanced defense systems too. The last one of which is Bavar 373. Hello everyone, I'm Shafi, and as always, welcome to the new episode of Polit Affairs. When a country is able to manufacture high-end assaulting weapons, it should also be able to manufacture sophisticated defensive weapons to be considered a military power. We all remember a few years ago when Russia tried not to supply Iran with the S-300 surface-to-air missile system with an excuse of sanctions. There was a time when Russia welcomed UN Security Council's resolution against Iran and voted in favor of it. I'm not going to talk about history and relations right now. Russia finally agreed to send those weapons to Iran, but only after making sure that Iran was not able to use them for defending against its enemies like Israel. Can you compare these measures with the fact that Iran is now supporting Russia in a real conflict, while Russia did not when Iran needed? Anyway, those years, military generals in Iran understood that they have to rely on domestic knowledge and potentials for manufacturing defense systems. And after almost a decade, here we are. The Bavar system is able to hit a target at a distance of over 300 kilometers with a new missile. Iran has officially unveiled an upgraded version of the Bavar 373 or the Believe 373 surface-to-air missile system with a range of more than 300 kilometers. The unveiling ceremony was attended by Iranian Defense Minister, during which the system was successfully tested by launching a long-range Sayyad B-4 or the Hunter B-4 missile. During the test, its upgraded radar managed to detect a target at a distance of more than 450 kilometers and track the target at a distance of about 405 kilometers before destroying it at a range of over 300 kilometers with 8 Mach speed and 30 kilometers altitude. The target was a Carrar suicide drone, which flies at a speed of 700 kilometers per hour. This is especially important because Carrar is a relatively small bird, having very little wings and is only 5 meters long. It was said during the test that the missile system is able to detect and shoot down 5th generation fighters, especially because they are much bigger than what has been tested. So here we know whose fighters might become the main prey for this system. Israel, which always plans to invade Iran using modern American fighter jets, such as F-35. Prior to the upgrade, the Bavar 373 missile system was capable of detecting, tracking, and hitting targets at ranges of 350 kilometers, 260 kilometers, and finally 200 kilometers, respectively. On the sidelines of the ceremony, the production line of the Sayyad B-4 missile, which run on combined solid fuel, was also inaugurated. The employment of the Sayyad missile means that the range of the Iranian air defense system missiles has been extended, and that the altitude of the engagement has also been increased from 27 kilometers to 32 kilometers. The Bavar system made its first official appearance on August 2019. Some believe it's the Iranian version for the S-300 Russian missile system, but others believe that it's more similar to the Russian S-400 missile system. As you might know, operational range for the Russian S-300 is up to 150 kilometers. For the S-400, it's up to maximum 400 kilometers. So being able to target fighter jets, bombers, drones, and even ballistic missiles from 300 kilometers is a breakthrough for the Iran's army. This operational range is more than some versions of the American Thought and Patriot systems. Iran now has lots of older purchased anti-air missile systems, from British Rapier, American Hawk, HQ-7 SAM-6, to the Russian S-200, S-300, and even TOR-M1. But in the domestic industry, there are also many more systems, from this full anti-air missile system, Majid, Zubin, Rad, Sayyad, 15th of Khordad, 9th of Day, and Mersad 16, to Sevom Khordad, which has the experience of shooting down most expensive American drone over Persian Gulf, the RQ-4 Global Hawk. Now, Bavar is the big boy among all of them, with the longest range. The incident for the American drone in 2019 proved the quality and precision of these domestic systems. like the story of ballistic missiles and drones, which many thought are just toys, but then everyone saw the truth. Now, the Iranian generals really believe in what their soldiers and technicians are making, especially in this sphere. I remember 2 years ago, Russian media wrote that Moscow has offered Iran to buy S-400 missile system, a system which is a big player in this sphere. And Turkey has already purchased it, despite huge objections from NATO and especially United States. At the time, one Iranian general said, "Thank you for being so generous, but we believe in what we have." Actually, Russia offered S-400 when they saw Iran has tremendous capabilities itself. If not, Moscow was not ready for such a deal, like in the case of S-300. Now, this Bavar system could be considered as a powerful rival for the Russian S-400, and the fact is that it operates even faster than that and gets ready for firing missiles in like 4 minutes. There was a time Western media made jokes about Iran not being able to purchase such weapons from its so-called ally Russia, but now we see that Russia is asking Iran for weapons. Here I want to say my opinion honestly. You may hate the ruling government in Iran for its domestic and foreign policy, but seeing an important and historical nation rise again and compete with big powers is quite good. Iranians now have the knowledge to manufacture high-end game-changer weapons, and they have developed it inside this country. So the knowledge stays here, no matter what government would rule the country. Iran, under any regime in its thousands of years of history, has always been defending, not attacking, never tried to be the aggressor. So despite all the attacking weapons they have manufactured, defensive ones are more important and effective, because in the end of the day, Iran has always been invaded, like 4 decades ago by Saddam Hussein. Who knows, maybe another Saddam Hussein is in the region. So Iran will again be invaded and should be ready to defy. Let's bring an example for you. I don't know if you're a football fan, you'd understand what I mean. For example, let's imagine that if Manchester United, Inter Milan, or any other big team, after a long absence, returns to the European Champions League and shines. Even if you don't like the team, the manager, the players, you'd still feel good about it, because for a football fan, watching Manchester United and Inter Milan back and shining is satisfactory. I don't know if you get the point or not. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to check out other videos on my channel and share your opinion with me in the comments.